Hello friends, I hope you are doing great. Once again, you are most welcome in my YouTube channel, Wired Loop Robotic and Automation. Today we are going to interface CSR04 ultrasonic sensor with Raspberry Pi Pico board, and we will make a distance meter by using MicroPython programming. So let us get started step by step. This is a schematic diagram. This is LCD with I2C board, and this is ultrasonic sensor, and this is Raspberry Pi Pico board. Now we will talk about connection. So ground pin is connected to ground, and here ground pin of LCD is connected to ground of Pico board. Okay, you can see eco pin is connected to GPIO 2, and it is pin 4. Okay, you can say GP2 or pin 4, and trigger pin is connected to GP3, it is pin 5 number. Okay, and VCC is connected to 14 number pin of Raspberry Pi Pico board, it is 5 voltage output, and VCC is common to this LCD. And here SCL pin is connected to GP1, it is second number pin, and SDA pin is connected to GP0, it is first number pin. Okay, so I hope you understood this. Now we will go to programming. So I will open Tony IDE. Now I will connect the board. Press on a stop button. I have already created the program. I will open that. This is library for LCD, and this is I2C library, and this is main code. So first of all, I will open this library. I'll copy this and I will paste here. Save this in Raspberry Pi Pico board, and name will be lcd_api.py. Okay. Now we will open this library. Select and copy. Its name is pico_i2c_lcd. Again, create new file, paste, and save in Raspberry Pi Pico drive. pico_i2c_lcd. Okay. .py. Okay. Now I will open this main file. Select and copy. Create new file. Paste. Save Raspberry Pi Pico drive, and here main.py. Okay, I will explain this step by step. I am using here I2C and pin class from machine library, and LCD API class from LCD API library, I2C LCD class from Pico I2C LCD library, and macro time and time. We are using these things. This is trigger object. Trigger pin is connected on 3 number GPIO, and it is as a output. It is echo object. Echo pin is connected to GPIO 2, and it is as a input. This is I2C object. We are using I2C 0, so SDA pin is 0 and SCL pin is 1 GPIO. This is LCD object. We are using I2C LCD, and this is I2C address. This is LCD type. First of all, trigger pin will be low for 2 microsecond, and then trigger pin will be high for 5 millisecond. That time trigger pin will send the pulse to the object and it will hit the object and get back to the echo pin. That time signal variable will store the time stamp when echo pin will not receive any pulses. Okay, so signal off variable will store the time stamp in microsecond. If echo pin will be high, it means if echo pin get the pulses, that time signal on variable will store the time stamp in microsecond when it get the pulse. Okay, time pass variable, this line calculate the total time taken when pulse leave to the sensor and hit to object and get back to the echo pin. Okay, so it is the total time taken. Okay, here we can calculate the distance by using total time taken multiply by velocity of the sound. So you know velocity of the sound is 0.0343 centimeter per microsecond. Okay, it is divided by 2 because we want only distance from sensor to object. Okay, so it is distance, and here distance will be printed on LCD in centimeter. So I hope you understood this. Now we will upload this code. Now I will run the code. Okay, now I will place an object. You can see now distance is 4.3 centimeter, and now I will increase the distance is increasing. Wow. And I will decrease the distance. You can see distance is decreasing. Okay. So friends, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you really like this video, so you can support me on PayPal. My PayPal account is given in description box. And don't forget to like, subscribe and share. Thanks for watching.